With programming becoming a more popular job, and with things like Wix and Squarespace taking away programming jobs, is it really too late to become a programmer? Welcome back to Web Dev Simplified. My name's Kyle, and my job is to simplify the web for you so you can start building your dream project sooner. So if that sounds interesting, make sure you subscribe to the channel for more videos just like this. Now, this question I get asked all the time. Hey Kyle, is it too late for me to become a programmer? Hey Kyle, is web development oversaturated? Is Wix and Squarespace going to take all of our web development jobs? Am I really going to be able to get a job, or is it just too full? The market is too full of junior developers. And every single time, the answer for me is no. You're going to be just fine. There's no oversaturation. There are not too many people with your jobs, and there are definitely not too many jobs being taken over by Squarespace and Wix. If that's all you cared about, you can leave the video now. Sorry, see ya. But if you want really a more in-depth answer of why this is true, you should stick around until the end of this video. So in order to understand exactly why this is, let's kind of rewind a little bit to when I was in college studying computer engineering with the end goal of getting a web development job. And I thought this was the perfect path. You go to school, you get a job, and you're set. Web development, computer science, it's a great career field to get into. But at this time was when boot camps really started to gain a bunch of popularity. People started graduating left and right from boot camps, and they had tons of experience because in a boot camp, you're learning specifically web development. While in college, I'm learning everything but web development. Literally didn't get taught any web development at all. So these people coming from boot camps had way more experience than me. They had more applicable skills. They had just essentially everything that a company wanted, while I had nothing. I mean, I could build you out a site in C, I could write assembly code for you, but is that really useful? No, not at all. So was it too late for me? I wasted my time in college for 4 years only to realize when I graduated, every other person out there that went the bootcamp or self-taught route knew more than me about web development and had more applicable skills that they could apply to a job. But I still found a job immediately. I didn't have to wait around a bunch. So technically, if you looked at the climate, it was too late. The market was super saturated with junior developers with good web development skills, and I had terrible skills and no web development knowledge, but I was able to land a job as a web developer. And that's because even if there are tons and tons of people with the skills of a web developer, there are so many more jobs out there for web developers, and the job market is going to continue and continue to grow year after year after year because people need websites. Unless the internet just disappears tomorrow, there are going to be constant need for web developers. And even if the internet did disappear, there's still going to be tons of demand for programmers in general because web development is only one small little subset of programming. And there are so many jobs out there for programmers since literally everything deals with programming. You know, your microwave even needs to be programmed. So everything in this world essentially deals with programming. Everybody has a phone, and phones are just super complex. There's games, there's websites. There's just endless applications of programming concepts. So no matter what happens, there's going to be jobs out there for programmers. And the job market may seem saturated because there's so many people coming in from dev boot camps and so on, but it's only a fraction of the number of jobs that are actually out there. This topic, though, of everybody needing websites kind of leads into the point of, well, why don't people just use Squarespace or Wix or WordPress to build out their sites? And these are great options for people that need really simple sites, like your local barbershop doesn't really need a custom site. They could just use Squarespace or Wix and get by perfectly fine. But what about Google? What about Facebook, Instagram? Are they just going to use Squarespace or Wix to build out Instagram? No, that's impossible. The web is mostly built out of simple websites that Squarespace or Wix could serve perfectly fine. But the real bulk of development work is in web applications like Facebook and Google and Amazon. And these require thousands and thousands of developers in order to ensure that they're running properly. And nothing is going to replace those jobs. There's no Squarespace or Wix out there, or even the possibility of a Squarespace or Wix in any future environment that I can think of that is going to replace these web development jobs. Because there's so much complexity that goes into building things like Amazon and Facebook and Google, and even just building Squarespace and building Wix. You need real developers to do that. You can't build Wix with Wix. The way that I look at it is that even if we build out a crazy computer that can actually build websites, even web applications, we build a computer that can build out Facebook, we're still going to need developers to work on the computer that is building Facebook. So even if you build something amazing that can do what you currently do as a web developer, you're going to need someone that's going to work on that amazing thing that you just built. So by creating something that removes jobs, you're creating something else that creates jobs, and really it's just an endless cycle. Unless we get to the point where computers start building computers that start building web applications and other things, we're going to need developers to work on the things that we're using. And whether you're going to be hard coding and building websites directly, or you're going to be working on tools like Wix and Squarespace that help you build out the websites, it really doesn't matter because at the end of the day, you're going to be doing programming and development work. I know there's tons of headlines out there that say Squarespace and Wix and all those other things are killing web development jobs and boot camps are oversaturating the market, but really, those are just there to get clicks and to get clickbait and views and so on. Maybe there are more devs. Maybe there's double the amount of junior developers being graduated from boot camps than there were in the previous years, but there's still so many jobs to fill, it doesn't matter. It's not going to make a huge dent and a huge impact on your ability to find a job. And while Squarespace and Wix do make it so certain places like barber shops and so on don't need you to build out a website, they still need people to build out Squarespace and Wix, so you're going to be just fine finding a job. Honestly, the only time that's too late to start is tomorrow, because you should be starting today. Don't wait to start because it's too late, and don't wait to start because, oh, I'll do it tomorrow, because you'll never actually start. You just need to start today. Start becoming a web developer today, and you will get to the job that you want eventually. If you always constantly sell yourself that it's too late and that you're not going to start, then yes, it's too late for you because you've given up on yourself. What you need to do instead is just start now, get that job, learn those skills, and eventually you're going to be a programmer or web developer or whatever you want to be. And if you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about programming and web development, check out my videos linked over here and subscribe to the channel for more videos just like this. Thank you very much for watching and have a good day.